Hello, child of God. Over the centuries, the Christian church has experienced awesome revivals in many different times and places. Every modern Christian denomination has experienced in the past a revival of some sort. Many of their church historians have recorded and included eyewitness testimonies. In these modern days, there are also accounts of the Lord Jesus Christ manifesting himself to the religious leaders of several non-Christian religions. Among those I have heard about are some Buddhist, some Muslim, Hindu, and Jewish leaders. Usually the conversion of that religious leader begins a Christian revival within the religion he represents. My own opinion is that the very best of these past revivals are the ones that I personally attended. Those are the revivals that the Holy Spirit made the largest positive change within me. So as you can see, the greatness of the revival is relative to the opinion of the person who is experiencing the work of the Holy Spirit. During these last few months, I have been experiencing a great revival. This is a continuous revival within me as I practice the presence of the Holy Spirit. As I become more and more aware of the presence of the Holy Spirit within me, that awareness seriously affects my words and actions. I'd like to present a few scriptures and explanations to help each one of us remain focused on the presence of the Holy Spirit within our body and in fellowship with our own human spirit.
If thou knewest the gift of God, and who it is that saith to thee, Give me to drink, thou wouldest have asked of him, and he would have given thee living water. Whosoever drinketh of this water shall thirst again, but whosoever drinketh of the water that I shall give him shall never thirst, but the water that I shall give him shall be in him a well of water springing up into everlasting life. Woman, believe me, the hour cometh when ye shall neither in this mountain nor yet at Jerusalem worship the Father. Ye worship ye know not what. We know what we worship, for salvation is of the Jews. But the hour cometh, and now is, when the true worshippers shall worship the Father in spirit and in truth, for the Father seeketh such to worship him. God is a spirit, and they that worship him must worship him in spirit and in truth.
Wow! The Lord Jesus Christ just introduced the entire Trinity to this sin-filled Samaritan woman at the well. He said, Woman, if you knew the gift of God, Jesus just introduced the Holy Spirit. And if you knew who asked you for a drink of water, Jesus introduced himself, that is, the Spirit of God the Son in a human body, Emmanuel, God with us. Jesus also said to the woman, You do not know what you worship. Then Jesus introduced God, our Heavenly Father. He said, God is a spirit and is seeking to be worshiped as a spirit. The real living person that you are is a human spirit, and you now live in a body made from dirt. When the Lord Jesus Christ went to heaven, he sent the Holy Spirit to live in the human bodies of the children of God. You are sealed until the day of redemption. Your body has become the temple of the Holy Spirit.
There is therefore now no condemnation to them which are in Christ Jesus, who walk not after the flesh, but after the Spirit. For to be carnally minded is death, but to be spiritually minded is life and peace. So then they that are in the flesh cannot please God. For if ye live after the flesh, ye shall die. But if ye through the Spirit do mortify the deeds of the body, ye shall live. For as many as are led by the Spirit of God, they are the sons of God. For ye have not received the spirit of bondage again to fear, but ye have received the spirit of adoption, whereby we cry, Abba, Father. The Spirit itself beareth witness with our spirit that we are the children of God, and if children, then heirs, heirs of God, and joint heirs with Christ, if so be that we suffer with him, that we may be also glorified together. Likewise the Spirit also helpeth our infirmities, for we know not what we should pray for as we ought. But the Spirit itself maketh intercession for us with groanings which cannot be uttered. And he that searcheth the hearts knoweth what is the mind of the Spirit, because he maketh intercession for the saints according to the will of God.
So now, what does the Apostle Paul actually mean when he said that we must walk in the Spirit and not in the flesh? Most of us would assume that the answer to be very obvious. Just be a good Christian and do not do bad things. But wait, let's analyze that assumption. Mentally, we have just elevated our own thinking to be like God, knowing right from wrong. And this is exactly what Satan wanted for the human race in the Garden of Eden.
For my thoughts are not your thoughts, neither are your ways my ways, saith the Lord. For as the heavens are higher than the earth, so are my ways higher than your ways, and my thoughts than your thoughts.
Now walking in the Spirit only begins with the awareness and the acknowledgement of the presence of the Holy Spirit within our own bodies. Walking in the Spirit involves obeying the directions of the Holy Spirit. Jesus said plainly, "My sheep know my voice, and they will not follow the voice of a stranger." Well, the Holy Spirit will certainly speak to us, but even when we have not learned to listen to His voice, He directs us in many different ways. And the Holy Spirit prays for us in groanings that cannot be uttered. Within our bodies is the Spirit of God, the Holy Spirit, whom is praying to Almighty God the Father, and the prayers are being answered by the Lord Jesus Christ, whom is the Son of God, and He's seated on the throne beside Almighty God the Father. Walking in the flesh is living in a sin-induced coma, unaware of the magnitudes of the efforts of Almighty God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit to save our human spirits from the eternal torments.
Know ye not that ye are the temple of God, and that the Spirit of God dwelleth in you? If any man defile the temple of God, him shall God destroy. For the temple of God is holy, which temple ye are. Know ye not that the unrighteous shall not inherit the kingdom of God? Be not deceived. Neither fornicators, nor idolaters, nor adulterers, nor effeminate, nor abusers of themselves with mankind, nor thieves, nor covetous, nor drunkards, nor revilers, nor extortioners, shall inherit the kingdom of God. Know ye not that your bodies are the members of Christ? Shall I then take the members of Christ and make them the members of an harlot? God forbid. What? Know ye not that he which is joined to an harlot is one body? For two, saith he, shall be one flesh, but he that is joined unto the Lord is one spirit. Flee fornication. Every sin that a man doeth is without the body, but he that committeth fornication sinneth against his own body. What? Know ye not that your body is the temple of the Holy Ghost which is in you, which ye have of God, and ye are not your own? For ye are bought with a price. Therefore glorify God in your body, and in your spirit, which are God's.
Well, child of God, revival is not beating ourselves up with a guilt trip because of our many sins. Revival is turning away from the lust of the flesh, the lust of the eyes, and the pride of life. And as we turn away from sin, we are turning to the real living God person that lives within our body along with our human spirit. Let's practice the presence of the Holy Spirit as we listen to an invitation from the Lord Jesus Christ Himself, the Son of the Most High God.
And behold, I come quickly, and my reward is with me, to give every man according as his work shall be. I am Alpha and Omega, the beginning and the end, the first and the last. Blessed are they that do His commandments, that they may have right to the tree of life, and may enter in through the gates into the city. For without are dogs, and sorcerers, and whoremongers, and murderers, and idolaters, and whosoever loveth and maketh a lie. I, Jesus, have sent mine angel to testify unto you these things in the churches. I am the root and the offspring of David, and the bright and morning star. And the Spirit and the bride say, Come, and let him that heareth say, Come, and let him that is athirst come. And whosoever will, let him take the water of life freely.